Sacramento and Company.
You're watching Sacramento and Company live.
Welcome back. We are live.
Yes, we are live.
Okay.
Just in case you were wondering.
Yeah, and we're ready. We're ready to go. I love mornings, but not everyone shares that particular viewpoint. So you drink your coffee, you make your bed, you eat your breakfast, you shower, you get dressed. Some of the things most of us do before we leave for the day. Is it possible to do more than just those basics before 8 a.m.?
Well, our next guest says we all have the ability to drastically enhance and change our lives for the better each and every morning. Motivational speaker Hal Elrod is the author of The Miracle Morning, a foolproof plan, if I can get that out of my mouth, to motivate the unmotivated.
Yes.
Yes.
Yeah.
So you've been on the show before, and you talked to us about your book that you wrote your previous book, Taking Life Head On. Yeah. Now you've moved on to The Miracle Morning. What is The Miracle Morning about?
The Miracle Morning is, it's also called the not so obvious secret that's guaranteed to change your entire life before 8 a.m. And it's really a proven way to wake up every day with more energy, more motivation, and really to find more time so that you can create the life that you really want.
Lay it on us.
And Hal, what we want to share as well, your story is incredibly motivating that brought you to this point. Can you step us back to how you started doing this and arrived at this?
Yeah, well, I mean, initially my story that I shared before that my first book was about was when I was 20. I was driving home from work one night in my first new car, and a drunk driver got on the freeway going the wrong way at about 80 miles an hour, hit me head on.
Ugh.
And I spun off the drunk driver, and a car behind me hit me in the door at 70 miles an hour, and I was found dead at the scene. My heart stopped for 6 minutes, and 6 days later, I woke from a coma to find out that I had permanent brain damage, that I might never walk again, and not to mention I had 16 major injuries from broken bones to a ruptured spleen to a punctured lung, you name it. And so that's what the book was about, was really sharing how I overcame that to get here today.
Wow. So how did you come back from that? Where did you find the strength and the... Or where did you draw your inspiration from?
You know, I mean, there's a lot of support from other people, but it was ultimately, it was really through learning, reading, growing. It was through becoming a more capable person so that my circumstances were then more manageable. And I think that's the big thing that people miss, is that we all want our outer world to change, right? But we're not taking time to develop our inner world. And so there's a disconnect. If you want a level 10 life, but you're at a level 2 in terms of your personal development, it's always going to be a struggle. But if you develop yourself to be a 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, success is going to come easy in every area.
And you found so many people were touched by the message in your first book, Hal, that you decided to do The Miracle Morning. Can you share a little bit more about the kind of secrets? It's getting a lot of web publicity right
sure.
now, too. And you've been all over the country.
Yeah, I was on TV in Houston yesterday. And
and today you're here in Sacramento.
Yeah.
It gets better, on to bigger and better things, Sacramento.
Well, thank you very much.
No, well, yeah, the way The Miracle Morning came about is about 2 years ago, I had really hit rock bottom. And rock bottom financially, physically, mentally, emotionally, spiritually, you name it. What happened is the economy started to plummet. And like so many people, I lost over half my income, couldn't pay my bills, racked up $50,000 in credit card debt, lost my house.
Oh my gosh.
And because of that, I got really depressed. And one day I went for a run, and I couldn't solve my problems. And one day I heard a quote from Jim Rohn, famous author. He said, success is something you attract by the person you become. And it was in that moment that I ran home and I thought, I've got to dedicate time every single day to doing all these things I've heard about for years, right? Visualization, meditation, reading, exercise, affirmations, all these things. And so I created this thing called The Miracle Morning. And like you said, the web, it went crazy. One person told another, and now thousands of people are posting it on Facebook and Twitter and YouTube.
And how it changes their lives.
Yeah, and currently The Miracle Morning is online for people to get a taste of it. And you also have...
I brought gifts, audio program.
Wow. Audio
for you
program.
Too.
Okay. Oh, thank you.
Yeah,
very
the
much.
Book is being
thank
written.
You.
But
okay.
It's not, the book will be out later this year, but right now you can go to miraclemorning.com and download my 60-minute audio for free. And that's really what has brought all these people to wake up every day with more energy. And,
okay, well, give us a sample. Give us a tip.
Okay. I'll tell you that how you feel in the morning is based on the intention you decide on the night before. Think about this. Did you guys celebrate Christmas growing up?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
Was it hard to wake up Christmas morning?
No.
No.
No. Right. Did you feel tired?
No.
No.
And it was because you decided the night before how you were going to feel the next morning. And most people go, oh, I got to get up tomorrow and start it all over again. And then what's the first thought that goes when the alarm comes off? It's, oh, here's the morning, got to do it again. So if you want to wake up every day with energy, with clarity, motivation, simply decide the night before that that's how you're going to wake up. And that's what
we're
happen.
Doing it, Hal.
Ooh,
thank
we're
you
do
so
it.
Much, okay. And thank you for joining us, Hal.
Learn more.
Miracle
about
morning.
The miracle morning.
Good stuff promises to work even if you're not a morning person, and that's
exactly.
a tough thing for a lot of moms. They're busy, but they're also sharing tips like Hal did with us on how they stay inspired. And I like this one: how they fan the flames of their relationships on no sleep or when they don't have much time. It's on our sister site, sacramento.momslikeme.com, and we encourage you to check it out. Also, there's currently a hot couples contest. Nothing like positive praise, right, Hal?
Yeah.
You nominate your loved one with a photo. You can win a free dinner and a photo shoot just for nominating. You get
Are you
friends.
And Brian on there?
No, I didn't think we were eligible, but I definitely think he's
That
hot.
You're a hot couple.
No, I think he is. You can get ideas on how other moms are balancing family finances and relationships. So connect, join the conversation, momslikeme.com.
Okay, and just to let you know, every day on the show is like Christmas for me. When I go to bed
wow.
the night before, I think about tomorrow, I get to sit on the couch with Melissa and chat about fun stuff.
It helps me wake up, too. I'm excited.
All right.